Good afternoon, everyone. I'm State Senator Jeff Klein, the Deputy Majority Leader of the State Senate. We're going to be joined in a little while by our leader, John Sampson, but we want to start because we know everyone has a busy schedule here today. I'm very proud to stand here today with many of my colleagues to announce the formation of a bipartisan task force on government efficiency. I think everyone here saw the movie Groundhog Day. Well, our budget process is very, very similar to that movie because every year the same thing happens over and over and over again. Whoever the governor is, whatever political party, they always unveil a budget which has devastating cuts to health care and education. Things that people hold near and dear and things that affect people's lives on a daily basis. We're trying to think out of the box. Yeah, instead of always looking to cut health care and education, which people recognize is important to their daily lives, we're going to be looking at government waste. I think everyone understands in this tough economic time, we are asking New Yorkers all over the state to tighten their belts. Well, I think the time has come for state government to do the same. Already, I've released two reports that actually look at various agency spending. And we found, looking at SUNY and looking at Division of Correction Services, is sort of a pattern. The first thing is overtime. Last year, the state of New York spent close to $500 million in overtime. If you just look at SUNY, it's very, very disturbing that you have what I consider non-essential workers making a tremendous amount of money in overtime. We found gardeners at SUNY Farmingdale who made just alone $136,000 just in overtime. Three gardeners. We also found other types of abuses like locksmiths that were making $150,000 a year, $100,000 of that, again in overtime. I think it's important that we make a statement while people in the private sector all over our great state are losing their jobs, let alone not getting overtime, I think we have to lead by example here in the state of New York. The other thing that we found is problems with consolidation and problems with duplication of services. Again, getting back to the SUNY example, what we found was the SUNY has a SUNY campuses across the state of New York all have a separate police force. They have a separate uniform, a separate insignia. They also have supervisors of police at each campus, a deputy supervisor, an assistant to the deputy supervisor. The list goes on and on. Instead of having just one central organization, which administers the police at all SUNY campuses. As a matter of fact, there's more administrators at the SUNY police force at each campus, if you count up all the campuses, than the whole entire state police force combined. Just by consolidating the SUNY police, we can save $15 million a year. Now turning to the Division of Correctional Services. We found that the Division of Correctional Services is responsible for close to 20% of the total overtime in the state of New York. We found very low-level clerks, people who do not have to be there around the clock, again, making over $100,000 a year in overtime. One of my favorite examples is the nurse at Bedford Hills Correctional Facility in Westchester County, who last year made over $250,000. $150,000 of her salary, again, was in overtime. So I think by just getting a handle on overtime, reducing overtime spending, actually doing consolidations within agencies, we can save the taxpayers of the state of New York an awful lot of money heading into this budget session, which I think is very, very important. I think it's incumbent upon all of us, because we always hear the talk about doing more with less. Well, I think the time has come to finally do more with less, and I think the way we do this is by having this task force. We're going to have hearings. We're going to do individual investigations of every single state agency to see how we can find savings for the taxpayers of New York State. I just want to introduce my colleagues who are with me today. We have Darrell Aubertine. I know he's here. I thank Darrell for coming here today. We have Brian Foley, Senator Brian Foley from Suffolk County. I know Senator Craig Johnson, who's on the committee from Nassau County. Senator Betty Little joins us on the committee. Senator George Maziar from Western New York. He's not with us today, but one of our prominent members of our committee is Senator Tom Morahan from Rockland County. Senator Diane Savino represents a district in Staten Island and Brooklyn. One of my Bronx colleagues, Senator Jose Serrano, Senator Bill Stokowski from Western New York, Senator Andrea Stewart Cousins, one of my colleagues from Westchester County, and finally, Senator David Valesky. All of us, I think, are on the same page when we know, again, heading into this very, very difficult budget time, that we need to really save the taxpayers an awful lot of money. So I welcome any of my colleagues who would like to say a few words. George, would you like to say, or Betty?
Well, thank you very much. I again appreciate the invitation to take part in this bipartisan task force. As Senator Klein pointed out, you know, there's so much, what I would say is obvious duplication. You know, you have the New York State Department of Transportation. What do? They maintain roads and bridges. You have New York State Thruway Authority. What do? They maintain at least, you know, one very major interstate highway here. You know, isn't there something we could do? You have the New York State Liquor Authority. Basically, they do administrative and enforcement task forces. On the enforcement side, you have local police departments. You have county police departments. You have state police departments. I mean, I think having a separate enforcement unit just to do enforcement actions in one particular area of the law, the regulating liquor, is just a very expensive duplication. So I look forward to the working with this task force and hopefully saving the taxpayers some money, doing in government what they've done in private industry for years. Thank you, Senator.
George brought up an excellent point. In the governor's recent budget proposal, he advocated consolidating agencies, which came up with savings of about $14.6 million. Just by looking at the Division of Criminal Justice Services, just by consolidating their purchasing, which is done separately at every institution, at every prison, and actually their personnel department, we can save $25 million. And that's just one agency. So I think we're certainly on to something here. Betty?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. Cutting waste in government and looking at ways that state government can be more efficient is not a partisan issue. So I appreciate the opportunity to serve on this committee. It's a concern that we all have. Tough economic times have driven our families to tighten their belts, to cut coupons, to turn out the lights, and it's time that we looked at the state government and said, how can we do with less, and how can we cut the wastefulness in it? I had the privilege of serving on the Stan Lundeen Government Efficiency Commission, and I have talked about shared services, I think, since I came here. So I think it's very appropriate that we look at state government with the same eye and try to find ways that we can really get more for the taxpayer with their dollar than we are right now. So thank you very much, and thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Andrea, would you like to say a few words?
Well, again, I guess I just echo the sentiments of my colleagues and understand the responsibility that we have to find exactly what we're asking everyone else to find, those places where we can cut back, those places where we can be more efficient, those places that just plain make sense. And because it's been habitual, because it's the way it's always been done, it hasn't been looked at. This time, which is a very critical time economically, is also a time of great opportunity, clearly. And so this task force is I think at the appropriate time, the appropriate place, doing what is necessary, not only for now, but for the future as we go back to putting New York State on firm economic footing. So I'm very, very happy to be serving here.
Darryl?
Sure. Thank you, Jeff, and I'm certainly pleased to be here with all my colleagues to advance, you know, these issues. I think that government waste, duplication, and all the other topics that have been identified here are certainly very real. And there's a very real consequence to dealing with it. And the very real consequence is that we can, as Andrea just said, take the first steps toward putting New York State on strong fiscal footing again. And I want to commend leadership and certainly Senator Klein for pulling this together and, you know, taking these first steps in that direction. So thank you, Jeff.
Thank you. Senator Brian Foley.
Thank you, Senator Klein. This is a very important announcement today. every few years or every so often you hear of legislative branch undertaking these efforts. These are very important. I can speak by way of experience that when we had undertaken changes in a local government of a $250 million budget, we were able to save millions upon millions of dollars when we focused like a laser beam on different areas of different departments. And fulfilling our oversight responsibilities as a state legislature, I no doubt anticipate that we'll be able to bring that same kind of focus and that same kind of result. If we could, when I was supervisor in Brookhaven Town, save millions of dollars in a $250 million operating budget, I'm certain that we can do much better, of even a greater amount here in state government. I think that in and of itself is important about fulfilling our oversight responsibilities. Secondly, what's equally important is to regain the confidence of the public by demonstrating that we can work together in a bipartisan fashion. When too often we read or hear or listen to those who say it's impossible in these rather harsh times to find common ground, well, this is an area where we can find common ground, and the net result will be a more efficient, more effective governing, and at the same time save considerable taxpayer dollars. And I think for all of these reasons, this is going to be one of the signature initiatives of this particular legislative session. Thank you.
Thank you. David?
Thank you, Jeff. I want to thank Senator Klein for agreeing to lead this task force and build upon the outstanding work that he has done. I also want to acknowledge, again, the importance of this being a bipartisan task force. I think it dovetails very nicely with something that I've been calling for some time, which is a move toward a performance-based budgeting model in this state. The governor indicated in his executive budget his support for moving in that direction, and I think through this task force, working in a bipartisan fashion, we can take that to a whole new level. I would also indicate that I, for one, and I imagine my colleagues on the task force would agree, that we should not see this as an effort that applies only to this year's state budget. This should be an ongoing task force that continually reevaluates budget priorities and continually works to identify inefficiencies in state government, both now as part of this budget process and as we move past the adoption of the new state budget. So, Senator Klein, thank you very much.
Senator Stachowski.
Thanks, Senator Klein. I, too, am happy to be on this task force. I think we can find a great deal of savings and find a great deal of many ways, to make the government more efficient. I think just through joint purchasing through a lot of these departments that isn't going on right now, we can save a lot of money. So if we can do it that easy just in that area, we can look at some ways that maybe we can do some consolidations that work, and get more of these departments and agencies to work together to save money and make themselves more efficient in a fashion that maybe they haven't even looked at so far. So I look forward to joining the rest of my colleagues that are here today in getting this task force moving and trying to find the most savings we can to, as others have said, win back credibility for state government and get the people's trust back and make New York State a more efficient, transparent government. Thank you.
Senator Serrano?
Thank you, Senator Klein. It's a pleasure to join you on this task force with my colleagues in government. At a time when we're losing funding for things like services for children and for seniors, we really have to dig deep and look at some obvious ways that we could find some cost savings. And Senator Klein has tremendous credibility on this issue for his many years of advocacy on consumer protection and rooting out fraud throughout the city and the state. So I feel very confident in the work that he, as head of this task force, and all my colleagues here, could find creative ways to understand these agencies and understand how there is waste in them and how we can better root that out. Thank you.
Senator Craig Johnson.
Thank you, Senator Klein, and I truly appreciate the invitation to work with you on this committee. You working with me on the investigations and Government Operations Committee, we've already started putting our actions behind our words. Just earlier this year, we issued a report demonstrating the waste that was shown on the Governor's Island situation with the wasteful purchase of a $1 million ferry and wasting $1 million for taxpayer money. Clearly, we need to go and dig deep. When I served as a member of the Nassau County Legislature a number of years ago, as you may recall, at the turn of the century, Nassau County, facing the problems it was having with its deficits, started looking to fix its government by digging deep and finding the fraud, waste, and abuse that had occurred in its own government. It's clear that we have problems here. Your reports have demonstrated that, and there's much more to do. I'm just pleased to be joined by both Republicans and Democrats serving on this committee. I look forward to our work ahead. Thank you.
And finally, as I said, Senator Moynihan couldn't be with us today, but we are joined by his chief of staff, Jason Rashford. Jason?
Sure. First of all, Senator Moynihan sends his regrets that he could not be here personally. However, he believes deeply in the importance of this bipartisan task force. He sends his thanks to Senator Klein, along with his other colleagues, and he also would like me to extend his enthusiasm to begin work on this very important venture.